this is Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. Here, as a reminder, that the joy of the Lord is our strength. I'm going to share two examples. Now, for some of you who are really going through, you really, life seems to be kicking you in the teeth. You're going from trial to trauma to crisis to emergency to setback to frustration. And you are having a difficult time navigating through all of this. Well, I want to share with you two things that happened in my life where God's joy was truly my strength. All right. Now, you've heard this story before, but I'm sharing the latter half of it. During my first marriage, the second month of our marriage, my ex-husband came home bawling his eyes out, confessing that he had committed adultery with prostitutes. Second month of our marriage. Ooh! Yeah, exactly. So I had to get along with God. I was just stunned. I had to get along with God. God ministered to me in the restroom. Okay, and he enabled me to forgive. He gave me my peace back and calmed down all the hurt. And he ministered to me because I sat there and poured my heart out to him before I tried to deal with that confession. All right. From that point on, the next 3 years, I lived out of my emotions. I reacted to every single thing, every incident, every time he came home late. I worried in the morning. I worried at night. I watched my clock. I cried my eyes out. I went through all of that. And then one day I said, wait a minute. This is stupid. What am I doing? I'm not out there committing a sin. I need to take advantage of the promises of the Bible. Jesus said out of his own mouth, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Now, at that point, I went outside, gave him my hurts, my insecurities, my fears, my anxieties, my jealousies, my husband's adulteries, all of that. I just gave it all to him. I took out the trash, literally. From that point on, I was full of the joy of the Lord. I didn't worry. I'd see him come home knowing where he'd been and be written all over his face. And I'd say hi and talk about everything else or ask him if he wanted me to pray for him. But I never, ever attacked him. We never had arguments about that. From that day on, I was cool as a cucumber, baby. God filled me with so much joy that one day, this is so comical, one day my friend Eleanor and I were riding. We had just come out from church service. At that point, my ex-husband had graduated from encounters with prostitutes to a full-blown affair with a little girlfriend on the side. And I had already kind of prepared my friend that this was happening so she wouldn't be shocked if she ever encountered anything. But we pulled up in front of my house. I was going inside to change my shoes so we could go out and relax for the rest of the day. He, the ex-husband, is on his knees, leaning inside of the window, talking to his girlfriend who was sitting in the driver's side of her car. She had just come out of my house. I wonder what they were doing in there. Anyway, one side to get my other shoes, my, you know, my comfort shoes. And I looked at him and I said, hi. I just waved and I went inside. And she took off like a bat out. She took off like I was going inside to get my, I was going to get my shoes. I don't have a gun. So anyway, I go to get my shoes and I come out and he's looking all sheepish and ashamed. And I got in the car and Eleanor and I took off to get something to eat. Now, this was the comical part. My friend looked like she wanted to run him over. She was so angry. She was angry for me, which was cute. She and I have been best friends since 1983. So, you know, it's been a long friendship. And she was really pulling for me. And she was hurting for me. But I wasn't hurting. I was so full of the joy of the Lord. I thought the whole thing was so comical. And I don't mean phony laughter. I don't mean being phony like, oh, I don't care. No, no, no. God took all that out. Excuse me. That was a sneeze. He took all that out. All I had was, excuse me. All I had was joy and peace. That's all I had. I was so girded up inside by God. That's miraculous. Because that was my house they were in. And I could have had a hissy fit. But it didn't even bother me. See, I was already done in here. And God had me living my life, biding my time for him to give me permission to get a divorce. So anyway, and the reason I say that is because God works on each and every one of us. And sometimes people need time. Well, God gave him all the time and then told me, go on, you're released. Oh, finally I divorced him. But my point in saying that is he took the sting out of that. That whole scenario, him with the prostitutes, him with his girlfriend calling up, all of that, all the pain, it was non-existent. It wasn't just lessened. It was gone. That's what the joy of the Lord will do. Okay, number two. My husband, my love, the one that left me to go be with the Lord, he had 33 days. I've already told the story, so we'll get to the dying process right there. During the 33 days of him waiting to die, God infused us with so much love and joy. And we would play this music, and I would share testimonies with him about people who went to heaven and what heaven was like. And I am telling you, my husband and I enjoyed our love. We basked in it. We were so well sustained by God's Holy Spirit filling us with his joy and his love that what most people would see as an ugly experience ended up being extremely beautiful. In spite of the mixed emotions of the mourning, you know, when a person is dying, you begin to mourn them before they're even gone. They're mourning their life before they're gone because they're letting go. They're going through the process of letting go of everything they loved and know. So all of that is going on. But in the midst of it all, God kept us. The joy of the Lord was our strength. And I say to you, whatever you are going through, instead of getting angry at God, instead of getting ticked and taken aback and frustrated and whatever your little issues are with God, remember this is life. Some of this stuff just comes with the package. Life. And God is there as a buffering agent. He is there to protect us, to shield us, to comfort us, to soothe us, to cover us, to protect. Oh, God is there. And he's there to heal us if we ask him for his healing. So I ask you, go to him and ask him to heal your heart. Go to him. Ask him to take all the hurt out. I don't care if it happened when you were 2 or 3 years old. He can take it out. 100%. Not like a headache that comes and goes and comes again. No. When God takes this pain out, baby, gone for good. So, I ask you, I beseech you, go to God. Go to him. He is your inner resource. He is the source of your joy, your peace, your comfort, your healing. He is the source of your strength. Go to him. Please. Don't try to battle through this thing by yourself. It's too big for you, baby. You need Superman.